Morning of July 15, 1939, above the Hickok Department Store building owned by Samuel Getzes at Skolta, Manila, a 1 kilowatt transmitter begins her maiden broadcast. Hal Bowie greets his listeners, "Good morning." The first words on air over KZRH. Later that year, Bertrand Silen joins KZRH as manager and makes it into a commercial radio station. KZRH's peacetime programming is music and news. Filipino audience dances to the tune from Glenn Miller and his orchestra and Louis Armstrong and other jazz big band musicians.
We interrupt this program to bring you a special news bulletin. The Japanese have attacked Pearl Harbor, Hawaii, by air. President Roosevelt has just announced.
Harry Rodenberg, a U.S. Marine sergeant, remembers that he heard over KZRH that the Japanese bombed Pearl Harbor.
Yesterday, December 7th, 1941, a date which will live in infamy. The United States of America was suddenly and deliberately attacked by naval and air forces of the Empire of Japan.
I have just listened with warranted American pride to the dramatic words of our president asking Congress to declare a state of war between the United States of America and the Japanese Empire.
Then a few hours later, Marine Sergeant Rodenberg takes cover as the Japanese planes bomb Manila, Subic, Clark, and other military installations in the island.
Hello, NBC. This is Rich Island speaking from Manila, and this time I've got a real scoop for you. Manila has just been bombed. In fact, right now it is being bombed. And without warning, Japanese bombers started bombing Fort William McKinley,
the Japanese continued to advance towards Manila.
As 1941 neared its end, the Japanese were succeeding in closing in on Manila from two directions. The Philippine capital passed into the hands of the enemy on January 2, 1942. The Nipponese claimed they were liberating the island.
The Filipino-American forces retreat to Bataan. KZRH manager Bert Silen and his technician Simon Cheng brings with them the KZRH broadcast equipment and set up a makeshift radio station at Corregidor. General Douglas MacArthur renames this makeshift station as the Voice of Freedom. As the situation becomes hopeless, MacArthur escapes to Australia over KZRH promises, "I shall return."
I came, I shall return.
The poorly armed, sick, and starving Filipino-American troops are no match for the battle against hardened, well-fed, and fully supplied enemies. Maria Teresa Valencia, then a young lady, remembers this event vividly in her memoirs. The highly emotional voice of Lieutenant Norman Reyes over KZRH announcing the fall of Bataan on April 9, 1942.
but Ann has fallen. The Philippine-American troops on this war-ravaged and blood-stained peninsula have laid down their arms.
Later, on May 6, 1942, Corregidor surrendered.
In late April 1942, Corregidor in Manila Bay was the last outpost to resist the Japanese invaders of Luzon. For almost a month, the Japanese bombarded the island fortress with every weapon at their command. Finally, on May 5th, 1942, Japanese assault units crossed the narrow channel separating Luzon from Corregidor and stormed the rock's sturdy defenses.
Hikaru Hata of the Kenpei Tai accompanies Jonathan Wainwright, MacArthur's successor, who then orders all American and Filipino troops to surrender. It is over.
Sir Carroll, Wayne M. Wainwright.
To put a stop to further useless sacrifice of human life on the fortified island, yesterday I tendered Lieutenant General Conway, the commander-in-chief of the Imperial Japanese forces in the Philippines, the son of the surrender of all American and Philippine army troops in the Philippine Army. This decision on my part will realize the forced upon me by mail entirely.
The Japanese takes over KZRH and renames it PIAM. Fidela Magpayo, popularly known as Tia Deli, returns on air and says that they are being paid with sugar, coffee beans, and rice. KZRH personnel Hal Bowie and Bert Silen are imprisoned at the University of Santo Tomas, which was converted into a prison camp.
The advantages of life in the greater East Asia co-prosperity sphere were dimmed into the consciousness of Filipinos of all ages.
Mga kababayan, ang mga hapon ay hindi natin kalaban.
Some Filipinos helped the Japanese in their campaign. In Manila Street, Filipino collaborationists spoke to their countrymen in Tagalog, a Philippine native tongue. The conquerors blamed the Philippines' troubles on the U.S. A month later, the Philippine Commonwealth government was represented by its president in exile, Manuel Quezon. The first step toward Philippine independence, so hopefully planned 7 years earlier in Washington, had received a staggering setback.
Then, on October 20, 1944, the Americans land at Leyte. General MacArthur fulfills his promise to return. In 1945, Japan surrenders. The world sighs with relief and it begins the painful task of rebuilding. The country is in ruins. Economy is in shambles. Hal Bowie is released from a Japanese prison camp and returns to the States to buy new transmitters while Bert Silen look for funds. In 1946, the brothers Joaquin and Manuel Elizalde agree to finance the project. Maestro Federico Elizalde joins his brothers as head of the Manila Broadcasting Company, the parent firm of KZRH. Like a phoenix which rises from the ashes, KZRH is back on air on July 4, 1946, this time at Insular Life Building on Plaza Moraga, in time to cover the inauguration of President Manuel Rojas. Since then, it has never missed any single inauguration of Philippine president.
After 48 years of American sovereignty, the people of the Philippines assume the status of an independent nation. The transfer is made on the 4th of July, a day full of
KZRH is privileged to see the Filipino flag flying alone on the wind for the first time as a sovereign nation.